That's alright. Don't worry about what the fuck I be doing.
A cup of tea, fam.
Alright, cool, yeah.
Do you have my milk this time? No. Not no tin milk.
Carnation.
Not no evaporated milk. Not no carnation milk. Some normal fresh milk.
I don't drink tea, yeah? Mm. What, give me some of that peppermint.
You don't put sugar in those teas, you know?
You do.
Nah, you don't.
You do, right?
That's basically...
That's disgusting.
Just focus on your own tea, bro.
That's perfect.
Oslo, Norway. We basically decided to go and see Bryson Tiller.
Yes.
Yeah.
He was on his European tour and we thought, we've never been to Norway.
Yeah.
Why not go to Norway to see it?
Just for clarification, so like, people don't watch this video and come back and they're like, you guys are moist, man. Flew to the next country to go see Bryson Tiller. We didn't go to the country to see Bryson Tiller. We went to the country to see the country. It was just working out in perfect timing so we could also go to the Bryson Tiller concert so we could have two motions at the same time. Do you get it?
I don't really think that's accurate, to be honest with you.
I can't lie, I wouldn't think it's accurate.
No, it is like,
yo, bro, if you love Bryson Tiller, you love him, man.
Own it. Own it.
This what happened when I think about you. I get in my feelings, yeah. I start reminiscing, yeah. Next time around, fuck, I want it to be different, yeah. Waiting on a sign, guess it's time for a different prayer. Lord, please save her for me. Do this one favor for me.
I think it was about a month before that we're definitely gonna go, and that's when we booked our tickets with Ryanair, which cost us about £40 each as a return.
No.
You
want to take this bit?
Yeah, no.
Okay, it cost us at the time £40. Okay. What had happened was... We had a long weekend. It was my responsibility to check everybody in, but I didn't.
One thing you don't want to do is go with Ryanair and don't check in beforehand because...
Our flight cost £40. To check in, £50 each.
More than the actual flight.
More than the flight. I still, to this day, I was just like, how can they get away with that?
There's a woman on the check-in desk at all times. So... And all they're doing for you is writing your name in a computer and printing a piece of paper. And it costs £50 to do that.
You can check in, but you have to either have a mobile boarding pass.
Or a paper
one. If you don't, if your mobile doesn't, in this day and age, I don't know why I shouldn't, have access to get a mobile boarding pass, then you have to print off your pass. If you don't print it off, that cost you £15. It took us like a few hours to get there. I can't remember how long the flight was.
2 hours. 2 hours, hour and a half maybe.
There was either a bus that we could pay individually for, or there was, then we found the taxi man at the end cleaning his car. We all jumped out to get cash.
Yeah. I remember. That's when I got that first glimpse of what we got ourselves into.
When we asked her,
are you so like what's good in Oslo, like where's
supposed
to go
out?
I was
talking about how buff she was, sorry.
Oh man, see what someone's mind's always on girls.
Like, she was.
She's like,
why are you guys here?
Like, there's not much to do in Oslo.
Because you asked her, what do people do in Oslo on a Monday night?
That's what it was. We went on a Monday.
Oh my god.
Yeah. So we booked an Airbnb like a few days before. I don't know why we left it so late. And there was five of us all together. So
in Oslo, we had the two apartments, didn't we?
Yeah, like 40 a head per night, and then you say 80 a head for the two nights. Two bedrooms per flat.
Apartment flats.
It's very nice. See it.
Sorrel and ginger.
That's so weird.
No. I know my Caribbean know about sorrel and ginger.
I know my English folk know about PG tips.
You're not English, man.
I'm not English, I'm British.
I'm English.
Yeah, says you with a black skin.
don't say that too loud, my work people don't know I'm black.
Oslo just seems so clean. No litter on the roads, just nothing.
Yeah, I mean, you'd expect that for a boring city though, so.
You expect that for an expensive city. Their tax must be like, oof. No, remember we found out that stat.
I just don't remember what it was.
It was 40-something.
Yeah,
it was. 40K. Yeah, it's the average start. It was something, I can't remember what it was.
Then you have to, like, weight it, because the purchasing power of that 40K might match the purchasing power of 26K in this country. Yeah. Because
it probably does.
Everything is expensive.
And that's testament to how much we spent on food as well.
Yeah.
A normal 6 foot Subway, 6 foot inch. Whoa,
6 foot inch. 6 foot inch?
A 6 inch Subway that would normally cost you here about £3 cost us like £8 or £9.
Yeah.
Something ridiculous. And I saw the press and I was like, you know what? I'm not even that hungry no more, man. I bought breakfast utensils the next day and I think I spent £40, bro.
It's so pricey.
Six eggs, bread and some beans, man.
It's not a cheap place at all.
I don't think Oslo is known for its nightlife, which is why the young buff girl, should I say, in the money exchange place was like to us, why are you here? We were in Oslo in like what would be the height of their winter, so it was cold. And we were out on foot looking for places to go. At some point in the evening of us bar hopping, someone had the great idea, let's do some HIIT. And for those that don't know, what's HIIT? High intensity interval training. From one venue to another. We sprint for 30 seconds, then we jump. This is how shit this place was. Yeah, this is what we're doing for fun, because there's nothing else to do here.
No one on the streets.
Nope.
We'd have seen like five people in the venue that we go to.
And the amount of times our hopes were raised. Remember when we thought we had music?
Yeah.
Music.
Yeah.
Oh my god. We're lit.
Yeah, it's not about it.
Second day, what did we do?
We thought to see some sights.
Oh god.
What's the main attraction in Oslo?
Tapped it in. It's a castle.
It's like their Buckingham Palace. We made our way through their town centre. Because of how close we lived, we walked.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you, it was very picturesque. Like, it's very pretty. Like, once you get into the main city centre, everything looks really nice. There's cobbled floors everywhere with no chewing gum on the floors. But saying that, their main attractions are not the most exciting things.
Nah, he's making it nice. They were dead.
Rectangular shaped. Mm. It wasn't that big. I mean, I think
it's like something in gold is green. Like rich man's house.
That's what it could be. I think the courtyard in front of it was quite nice, and the view that you get from the sea when you know, when you look back was nice. And that's very picturesque. But yeah, I wouldn't really say you have to go and see it. Yeah.
I mean, you do have to go and see it because it's like one of the like three things that you see. When I was asking like what their local delicacies were, nobody could really tell me. Someone said,
no, it's a particular fish.
So yeah, someone said this particular fish, and I tried to find this particular fish, and like the three places we went into.
You weren't going to pay for that, man. Don't even try.
Was it expensive? I can't remember.
So food-wise, the one of our favourite European, or one of our favourite European, because he wasn't a fan, is like a fast food place called Max.
Mm. Is Max a European thing? I've only ever seen it in Scandinavian countries.
Basically, this is like a Sam's.
It's not Sam's. Don't ever disrespect that.
No, not Sam's.
I can't even remember what was wrong with it.
Yeah, the Max and Oslo
just wasn't good.
It didn't match up to what we'd had in previous countries. Oh, we also had what is like a Turkish restaurant, but we ordered Indian. So it's called Kebabish Original. We have some here in the UK, but it seemed to be much more of a bigger restaurant in Oslo. We had a very nice Indian. I actually enjoyed Indian.
Yeah, I don't know, man. Expensive, but I think it was like £40.
Fuck.
Yeah, so you can't get alcohol after a certain time, so definitely recommend to get the alcohol at duty free.
It probably is cheaper.
Yeah, it's probably cheaper.
We had a very, very heavy pre-drinking session.
Remember, we paid bullshit. Yeah. We had the straws and the thing. The big pitcher of vodka, pineapple juice.
This size.
Yeah, this size. And we had our glasses, which were our shot glasses, but they weren't even shot glasses. They were just normal cups. It wasn't a shot. Then you had your personal cup, which had your mixer and vodka in it as well. That game was super lit. I should have died. I don't know how I made it through that concert.
got in the camp on the way to Bryson Tiller. We're getting lit, we're having fun. We arrive at Bryson Tiller, and this is another example of how different a party and drinking culture is in Oslo. Like, I'll be honest with you, we were like probably making fools of ourselves.
Yeah, this is what I was thinking, because even though you say in the UK people are on the same kind of bar, we are still getting a bit normally higher.
We're
not so high that it's like absurd.
Because of the disparity between us and them, it made us, we had an out of body experience.
The first thing we all did was go toilet.
I will never forget that.
So we're in the toilet and we are making noise. We're doing singing so much. Everything. We're singing, we're dancing, we're having a good time because, as I said, we're extremely drunk. And this is what we do with drunk, we make fools of ourselves. And we walk straight into the main hall for the concert and we walk in and we're still making a racket. And I swear to you, it's like every single head in that main hall. Imagine you're in the Hammersmith Apollo and you walk in from the back and it's already packed and everybody's head turns and looks at you. You can hear a pin drop. Yeah. We were so licked and doing so much that everyone in that concert hall stopped to take us in.
Even the people at the front.
They were doing so little as well.
They were just standing.
For a concert, some people were even sitting down.
Yeah.
This was a standing concert. There were no seats, but people were
not really cool.
I thought, if it's packed, you must have like core fans that are here to enjoy themselves.
Because in Oslo, there's not usually a vibe when there is something to do. Even though you're not a core fan of that person, that artist, because it's an event, you go to it.
Yeah. You couldn't buy alcohol at Bryson Tiller.
Yeah.
Oh, do you know how stumped we were when we walked in? So we said, where's the bar? They don't serve alcohol in the whole place.
Certain people, I'm talking from Quay over there, start to trickle towards us. It's like they came out of their shell. Yeah. It's like we gave them the comfortability to actually turn up. Not to say that we're live at a party, but this might have been the first place I can actually fully say we were genuinely the life of the body. It's open with Day. They were actually turned up.
Oh, I forgot about Day.
We actually enjoyed it.
Yeah.
We actually enjoyed
good
it.
Good stage presence. Yeah. Energy, everything. Yeah, man.
The concert was good, as far as I remember.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, it was good.
It was good vibe. I am on a whole nother level. Ready, I'll be fucking off the question head. Fuck, can I get some getting no in here? Girls, my hand is showing you. Ladies, they ain't been killing them high. Gotta be sick of this guy. Pull up.
Once the show did get going, like everyone turned up.
Everyone got better. It did.
So this is the third and final example of how different and the party and the drinking culture is. Obviously, after the concert, there should always be an after party, right?
Goes without saying.
Who said that?
Jay.
After the show, it's the after party there.
Yeah. So, the show's done. Was there an after party? There was nowhere for us to go.
I'm literally going from one crowd to another crowd. Yo, what's the move, like?
We were like, we want to get some alcohol, innit? And like, let's create our own vibe. We got two apartments. We'll have our after party at one of the apartments. We're mingling with some girls. Yo, where do we buy alcohol from at this time of the night? They don't sell alcohol past six. They don't do what? They don't sell alcohol in Oslo past six.
What kind of turn down city?
Like, when are you supposed to drink alcohol? Why would you not want to drink it past six?
We had to buy alcohol off an alcohol shutter.
Oh, was it like one of the girls that said, oh yeah, I got some.
I got a guy,
I got a guy.
You have to have links for alcohol.
A guy had to come link one of our friends and sell him alcohol like he was selling him some cocaine or something. Yeah. We bought three Absolute 70cl bottles of vodka, Absolute vodka. It cost £50 per bottle. £50 for a small 70cl?
He said the guy was like, no, keep it down, like you can't, like just in case anyone drives past. Yeah. I think the car was even tinted.
We found out that there was one club that wasn't hosting an official after party, but people were heading there. We had been to the previous night. It was dead the night before, but after the concert, it was actually jumping. I'm not gonna lie, all the hip hop tunes, trap tunes, it's a club, so they were serving alcohol. So we got a girl from there and brought them back to the apartment.
We ended up having
an after party.
Because there aren't many things to do, we create the after party. everyone was already like gravitating towards it.
That evening was a good evening.
Yeah.
Because we made it a good evening. Yeah.
Waking up to see bodies just all over, just sleeping.
Oh my god.
Sofa, yeah. Floor, it was window, literally
like,
mirror.
I came out of the room and there was literally like three girls in the bed. Two of them had like basically no clothes on. The naked girl on the sofa.
It started off as a dead city, but the Bryson night made our whole trip.
Yeah, that was a good evening.
You definitely have to go to Oslo when something like that coincides with your trip. Make sure you go with lit people as well, because if you go like, because it's a turned down city. If you go with like someone that's people that's not really, you know, lively and can't really create their own vibe, you're gonna struggle there, man.
Yeah, and if you are going for some type of event that you know is on, go on that day. So if you go on that, let that day be your first day, because you'll meet people that are willing to turn up. So if you want to have something the next day, that's cool.
Yeah.
In regards to the vibe of it, there is none.
Yeah.
It's not even, like, I wouldn't recommend it. It's family, friends.
I would advise you to not go to Oslo on a Monday.
But I would recommend it if you want to go and do nothing.
Yeah, if you just want to take in the Scandinavia. If you've never been to Scandinavia, you could go there with a girlfriend.
Yeah.
And just like relax.
And the people are actually super friendly as well.
Yeah.
3 out of 10.
Oh, the country.
Two ratings, the country and experience.
The country, I say 4. Experience, 6, yeah, 6.5.
5 for the country. The second night of Oslo, I'd give that an 8. Yeah. But that first night was so bad, it was a 1.
Give the country a 4, the whole experience a 6. That's Oslo. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.
Peace out, 8 out down.